people, in this video you'll learn main tips on how to be able to shop on a budget in 2019, so definitely keep watching.
Whenever you are gone, I just wanna be with you. Please don't get.
Hello people, welcome back to my channel. Salut les amis, bienvenue et bon retour sur ma chaîne. Hola, bienvenue dans mon canal. Konnichiwa, watashi no channel ni yokoso. Hope you're doing fine today. This is another day, another week, and another video of me. Today was all gonna be a chatty one. They use for me and for my clients when it comes to shop on a budget and all the main hacks when it comes to it. Before even getting into the main hacks, I would say the most important thing when it comes to shop on a budget is to actually know your budget. We all have different budget and we all have different definitions when it comes to. Some people might find that a $20 t-shirt would be way too expensive and some others would be really cheap for them. So it's really important to think about it and really look at your lifestyle, look at your income, look at everything around it. Specify that first and to really look at your everyday life. I definitely made that mistake way before when I was younger to buy everything that I would look at and I would find really interesting, really pretty, I would just buy it. I have that way of going about my shopping impulses, if I could say it like that. Gonna wear the most and what you're gonna use the most. If any of you work in an office environment, you will spend a little bit more on that and a little bit less on other things like going out type of outfit, for example. You can actually buy, but buy a lot less. Make a difference by accessorizing up a little bit more. Into that a little bit deeper throughout this video. Let's get to it right now. Really important to define your style. I'll have that issue where you're gonna go to a store, you're gonna find a lot of pretty things, or you might not find anything you really like. Really dig deeper than that, you can realize that maybe you're not even aware of your own style. What I do with my clients most of the time is that we kind of lay out an action plan, what she wants to project in her life, what are her goals when it comes to it. You have that impulse or buying impulse, you're gonna buy a lot of stuff, but you're gonna go back home and you're gonna realize it's not even you, it's not even your style. Take a distance and just really look at your life, look at your goals, where you want to go in the next 5 years from now, the next 10 years from now, the next 2 years from now. All of that is going to be able to let you know where you want to go before even getting to the store. Much more simple for you when you're going to go to the store, because you're going to be able to know what you're really looking for. Not going to get as confused if you were to just go there without any other type of plan. Once your signature style done and you have all your action plan, you don't want to go crazy in stores, people. You just don't. And whenever we have the sales, it's a really good way and a really great occasion for you to buy really nice pieces for sure and a really nice price as well. There's a difference between getting something you really need and something you really gonna buy because of the price. That's because of the sake of the price being so good. Big question you need to ask before even getting to buy it is, is it gonna be versatile? How many times am I really gonna wear it? It's possible to wear it at least 2 minimum type of ways. You know my rules when it comes to styling and getting pieces that are able to use for so many type of occasions. Check my how to build a capsule wardrobe. Everything is gonna be there as long as my main tips when it comes to it. And then just waste pace and waste money on something that you're gonna end up wearing just once. Sales are good. You can buy something that's gonna be a little bit more expensive, or let's say a $65 pair of jeans, and that you can get tailored and that you're gonna be able to wear so many times with so many pieces and on so many occasions. So always, always think about the versatility of your closet and your pieces at the end of the day. I have my one-on-one with clients. First thing that I always, always tell them, keep it calm. Calm, you can control, you can do it. The tip to it is really to go to multiple stores as well, because whatever you're gonna find in one store could be at that price, but you can find the same thing and the same quality in another store, but less or discounted. The next thing is gonna be all about the basics. I've been talking about a lot and a ton. I'm energy to the quarry. I love having to being able to mix match in a unique and original way. When it comes to basics, great for that reason, be versatile. Any basic from day to night in just a couple of pieces away or a couple of accessories away. And again, I have my capsule wardrobe on my key pieces, 30 outfits based on my 12 main pieces. So it's gonna be somewhere here, black dress, a white button down shirt, a fitted blouse, a blazer, short sleeve, white t-shirt, like the one I'm wearing now, foundation of your closet. I'm never gonna say don't go with cray cray. Cray cray are the spices of your outfit, but you want to add them after you have your key pieces, basics, handled. The start of anything before doing anything else. Really invest in that. Anything solid color related, invest in that as well. A little bit more different from everything you're gonna see in the street, you're gonna add the spicy to simple color palettes. I'm gonna put a bat. But before getting to the bat, let's get to the white. You're gonna be able to match these basic colors to anything else that's gonna be a little bit more unique or a little bit more different. Talking about the black, the white, the brown, navy blue is a really nice neutral as well. That's why when it comes to denim jeans or denim jackets or just denim in general, you can style with something brown, you can style with something red, you can style with something green. It's neutral for that reason. And I do offer that kind of session with my clients where what is your color, is your palette, what is your color story. When it comes to getting ready in 5 minutes, you might as well get something that's gonna look amazing on your skin tone. Next thing I would say here is to accessorize. I've said that so many times. The last video was literally about that. Not only, again, it's not great for you to kind of keep the same outfit, it's a low investment. You might just get one pair of earrings or two pairs of earrings, not be overwhelming to your outfit. When it comes to jewelry, I think the most easiest thing to switch is the most easiest thing where you can add your personality even more. A lot of type of accessories. You have the scarves, you have the hats, you have the belts, you have the earrings, the rings, the necklaces. I love hats, you know me. Type of season when it's like really cold, because it's a really great way for me to not only protect that afro hair, but if I have to wear a Canadian winter coat that I hate, but I know I have to wear because I don't want to die, of course, where I'm gonna add a my touch. Think about the time and think about the money you're gonna save up to add a pop of color. Add patterns as well. Add the prints, the patterns, anything you feel comfortable in, and add prints that gonna be related to your own color story. Much more easier to go with something printed than to go with something much more solid. I'm gonna explain why, just hear me here. Especially colorful prints, it doesn't have to be cray-cray, one or two pop of colors. By this t-shirt, for example, you have a couple of shades here. You have an orange, you have a blue, green. You have a couple of shades that you're gonna pick, use, and choose a piece that's gonna have at least one color from that. I picked something that was yellow for reasons. Able to find some type of yellow shade here. I got something else printed, but polka dots to me are minimal prints. Stripes, any type of prints like that are easy if you want to combine them with another print. It's a way or a tool for you to know that when you add printed elements or when you add printed pieces, it doesn't have to be cray-cray. It doesn't have to be overwhelming. When it comes to having that on a budget, three printed pieces, for example, combine them or combine them with so many things from your closet if you stick to the same color story. Go from there. Don't go in multiple directions. You're gonna get confused, you're gonna get crazy, you're gonna be fed up, and you're gonna want to kill everybody here. And it's not the point of my video, of course. The point here is to make everything easier and more simple. Check consignment stores as well. They could be a little bit more expensive than the thrift shops or secondhand shops. It's low investment, but great quality value. They're gonna be a little bit more smaller. The difference between the thrift store and any consignment story is that a consignment story usually retails designer pieces most of the time, and a thrift store can find anything really, from a designer piece to something like Zara. It's gonna be a way for you to save up money and have great quality item at the end of the day, you know. Hope you liked it. I hope you enjoyed it. What was your biggest takeaway from that? Did you learn from half my lookbook ready? It's gonna be linked down below if you want to take a look at it. It's free for now. And don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell button so that you're gonna be notified every time that I have a video coming up. So, if you have any other type of question, I'm gonna have a couple of things in the next couple of months, so just subscribe to my magazine to be able to be notified first and probably get some nice discount of anything related to fashion, styling hacks. Everything is gonna be in this video, so definitely check them out. Really useful, really valuable. Said all the time, I'm gonna see you for my next video on Thursday on how to be able to style the jeans for your ship. For 2019, smile because it's free and contagious. Bye.